Alright, so in this video we are going to talk about multi-layer neural networks and why we need them. So back in Unit 1 we introduced the perceptron algorithm. The perceptron is a capable classifier, but it has one big limitation. It never converges if the classes can't be perfectly separated. Now to address this issue, we used logistic regression by adding a differentiable loss, and that then always converges to a loss minimum. Now, logistic regression is of course an improvement over the perceptron, but it still has a limitation. It can only handle two classes. If we want to deal with multiple classes, we have to make yet another modification. So to make logistic regression work for multiple classes, we have to add multiple output nodes and change the cross-entropy loss function. And yeah, we just did that in the previous videos when we talked about softmax regression. Now, softmax regression can handle multiple classes, but it still has a limitation. It can only create linear boundaries. To overcome this limitation of softmax regression, that it can only create linear boundaries, we add multiple hidden layers to it. So we actually modify softmax regression with hidden layers to get the so-called multilayer perceptron model. And the multilayer perceptron model can do both. It can deal with multiple classes, and it can generate pretty complex decision boundaries. The only caveat here is that with these additional capabilities, we need more data to tune it and train it to make it perform well. So to illustrate the benefits of these complex decision boundaries, consider the simple XOR problem. So here we have two classes, the orange class and the blue class. And we can see they are arranged in four different dots. So this is a case where we can't separate the two classes by a linear boundary. So logistic regression is pretty much useless here. However, using a multilayer perceptron, we can find decision boundaries where we can separate these two classes perfectly. I should say though, even though logistic regression or softmax regression can only do linear boundaries, it's still a very good model because it's simple. And I personally always used to start with a simple baseline. So before implementing more complicated models, such as multilayer perceptrons, I still recommend using logistic regression or softmax regression as a baseline. Here, a baseline means that we use a simpler model to get a predicted performance, and then with a more complicated model, we are trying to beat this performance. It's always a good idea to start with a simpler model so that we can debug our code more easily and get a quick performance estimate before we apply more expensive or more complicated models. So now that we went over the motivation behind the multilayer perceptron, let's now take a closer look of how the multilayer perceptron model looks like.